So, another update about Corona data. For those who have watched my last videos, I'm now preparing the data and normalize against the population of each country. And then you see here the percentage of the population who died. And you can clearly see that here Belgium is leading the chart here. Yeah, I've just dumped all the countries inside this single chart. So you see here the green one and the orange one, but also here in the faceted views, it's now normalized. So you can clearly see how severe the situation in Belgium is. So Damien, a friend of mine in the last video, had a comment that Netherlands and Belgium just started to count death Corona because they now started to test the cause of death. So that might actually explain why it's only going up so much at the moment. But still, those are the percentage values of people dying. So this means either the other countries are underreporting or we have a problem in Belgium. Anyway, it's going down, it seems. So this is a good sign. Then another interesting thing here is Canada is still on the risky side, in my opinion. In comparison to that, China looks really flat. And also here, Denmark is flattening. Czechia, I can't tell whether this is the beginning of exponential growth. We have to look at that. Ecuador going down. Egypt flat so far. France, good news here. So it seems the peak is over, the lockdown is effective, and we are seeing more linear and exponential growth here. So that actually means we have a R0 of around 1.1 or 2 or something, which is okay. Germany also hard to say. This here could indicate the rise of exponential growth, so we need to wait 1 or 2 days to see whether if it is effective or not, the lockdown, because the lockdown in France is much more severe than in Germany, and also it will be less severe in Germany soon, so we need to check whether this is a good idea or not. Then what else we see here, problematic curve in Ireland, so that could indicate exponential growth. Then we have Italy downward trend, so this is very nice. It's flat and more going downwards, so that's cool. But again, Italy still has a very, very severe lockdown. Netherlands also here going down, that's okay. Norway, you can't tell. It looks a bit like a beginning of exponential growth to me, but we need to wait a couple of days. What else here? Spain, that's a very, very clear trend downwards. That's cool. Also, the lockdown in Spain is very, very hard. Sweden is a bit concerning. We need to wait for 1 or 2 more days. The lockdown in Sweden is very light. So, not sure if this is going to work out. Switzerland is a bit oscillating. I think it's a data problem, but it's a bit risky. We need to check Switzerland still. UK also problematic in my opinion. Then United States as well. So we might see some effects of the lockdown there, but it's hard to tell. So we need to wait again. And Portugal also should be careful now. It's more or less flat, but you never know. Anything else we have to look at? No, I think also Turkey is constantly growing, so we don't see any downwards trend. Yeah, another thing is you see here, I'm running this in JupyterLab, and I've started to divide the notebooks into different notebooks for ETL, feature engineering, exploratory data analysis, and later I will also do some Whitebox and blackbox modeling, so stay tuned. Another thing is people ask me why I'm always running this in IBM Watson Studio. So this is plain Jupyter, so you can run it anywhere you like. I'm not forcing you to run it in Watson Studio. Just run it in every notebook environment you prefer. Okay, that's all, and maybe I will send you an update tomorrow. Thanks a lot. Bye.